Okay, so one way to enhance your game is to make little rooms which change depending on the conditions of the game. So at the moment in my game, when I pick up all the treasure here, these crystals disappear and I can get into the flag to finish the game. But what we could do is make this a little more interesting and challenging by building a little room for our monsters that they're contained in. Until we pick up the treasure, and then we can turn it into a race to who gets to the flag first. Okay, so at the moment, this is how the game looks. So I have to wander around and collect the treasure here, and when I've collected it, oops, those crystals should disappear, and I can get through to the flag. Okay, and then it's game over. But what we're going to do is change this a bit. So we've got the monsters contained until we pick up all of the treasure, and this is how we do it. So we know that when we pick up all the treasure, the crystals will disappear. So what I'm going to do is make a little room with the crystals. Okay, so I'm just selecting that with my object here. So we know these will disappear once our treasure has been picked up. Okay, so I'm going to take the monsters out, and I'm going to put them all in this little room. Okay. So, where's our monsters? So, you can put loads of monsters in if you like. You don't just have to have three, but I'm just going to put three in for the purposes of this. There we go. So, they're contained within there. Okay. And I could be really sneaky and maybe put like a treasure object up there. Okay. So, this is what will happen now. I can collect the treasure at the moment. And when I collect the last one, these will disappear and the monsters will be unleashed and will try and get me. Okay, so this is how it plays currently. So here's our monster friends stuck in the room, and I'm just going to collect this treasure up here. And hopefully, what should happen is when I collect this, the monsters will be unleashed. Okay, there they go. So, quite easy at the moment for me to finish. So what we can do is then make it a little bit more difficult. We could put some monsters sort of free reigning, oops, around the game. Okay, so any of these monsters would be good. We could increase the speed of one of the monsters, let's say the purple one. And we can make it double speed, for example, to make our game a little bit more difficult. Okay, we could enlarge our room here to give them a bit more space to roam about in. There's all sorts of things you can do, really. But this kind of is a little bit like the old Pac-Man where you have the ghosts in the middle and they kind of slowly escape and come after you. Okay, so here we go. This is our game as it stands. Okay, so we've got the monsters all contained within there. And, oh, died. So that monster's quite fast. And let's have a look. So let's go for these ones. And then they should all kind of break out of their little home. And now it becomes a little bit more tricky. As you can see, I've just died. So that's quite a good way of making your game a little bit more challenging. So cooping the monsters up in a little house, in a little room first. You could even do that with the main character, and she has to collect a certain amount of treasure before she's allowed out of her room. Okay? And that's how you do it.